Welcome back. Well, the big story today has been Kotak as well as MCX. The commodity markets are in focus with Kotak buying 15% stake in MCX. Sameer Shah, the MD and CEO of NCDX, now joins in on the phone line to share his thoughts with us. Hi, Mr. Shah. Thank you very much for joining in. First, I'm going to ask you about the valuation picture. Considering that the MCX deal was done at a valuation of around 3,000 crores, which is around 20 times its FY14 earnings, is it cheap as compared to some of the global peers, and what do you think about the valuations of the deal overall?
Firstly, thanks for getting me onto this call. I can't specifically comment on the valuation. All I can say is that this reflects the valuations reflect the current market scenario, and the current market scenario, given the happenings of the last 1 year in the commodities market, the commodities market has gone through quite a few issues, post-CTT, post-NSCL. So the valuations reflect the reality of the market.
Mr. Shah, good afternoon. And once again, thanks so much for joining in. You know, I was reading a report where they said that the average daily trading volume at MCX over the last 6 months is nearly one-third, at the time of its peak. So on account of the NSCL crisis, have you seen a change in the market share? Has it moved in your favor, NCDEX? And currently, can you tell us how the market share stands of the two entities?
Mr. Shah, what was your question again?
My question is, has the market share picture between the two entities, one is MCX as well as NCDX, changed over the last few months on the back of the NSCL crisis, and where does it stand now?
The market share certainly has changed on account of two things that happened. One is that the MCX volumes have reduced, as you rightly mentioned, and they have reduced for a variety of factors. One was CTT, second was NSCL, and third one was some of the irregularities that were pointed out at MCX by the PwC audit report. The second cause for shifting market share is because of things that have happened at NCDX and the new product launches that have happened. The market share now is more like, I'd say about 80%, 20% in favor of MCX, and sort of 15% with NCDX, and the remaining 3-5% with the rest of the exchanges. But the most important thing from market share perspective is not only to look at the volume market share, but to look at the open interest market share. The open interest is what generally reflects the trust of the marketplace. And the open interest market share has now significantly shifted towards NCDX. The gap between MCX and NCDX market share is now very small as far as open interest is concerned.
Okay, so do you expect the competitive landscape to now become even more difficult or more competitive because Kotak, or a heavyweight investor such as Kotak, has now entered MCX?
I actually think that the market environment will become more fair and more transparent with Kotak taking stake in MCX because of two, three things. One is that Kotak is not clear. It's an informed investor. So the fact that a informed institutional investor is now a significant minority shareholder in MCX will bode well from a corporate governance perspective and will make the competitive landscape more fair, transparent and healthy in my view.
Would you call this Kota coming in as a game changer for the industry?
I certainly think it's a positive step forward for three, and I think that I can attribute three reasons to this positive step forward. One is that it brings regulatory compliance under focus. So the regulator FMC had mandated that FPIL reduce its stake down to 2%, and this deal would have taken that step a long way. So this regulatory compliance step will increase market confidence. That's number one. Number two, fresh new money coming into the commodity exchanges bodes well for the commodity exchange industry. It just shows that the commodity exchanges have a significant potential to grow and be of relevance to the Indian economy. And the third is that as a well-informed institutional investor is now an investor in MCX. So I think all these three factors bode well for the commodity markets in general.
Okay. With regards to the Kotak deal or the Kotak MCX deal, Mr. Shah, do you see any regulatory or contingent liability such as a tax liability affecting it?
Well, I'm sure Kotak as an investor has looked at all those issues and has put safeguards in their share purchase agreement with the seller. But, you know, I'm pretty sure that you know those things would have been considered because this has been going on for the last 6 months or so. So I'm sure this has been factored into the investment decision.
Okay. You know, since Kotak is only coming in as a financial investor, all eyes will be on the kind of returns that they can expect. What, according to you, will be the industry growth rate going ahead?
I think Kotak would come in a lot more than just a financial investor. I mean, it is a strategic investor. I'm sure they would have loved to pick up a lot more than 15% if the regulations had so allowed. But at a significant minority of 15%, I don't think the Kotak Group is coming in as purely as a financial investor. They already have a presence in the commodity exchanges through ACE, which is their commodities exchange. And with taking stake in NCX, I think it's a lot more than just a pure financial investment.
Okay. All right, Mr. Shah, thank you very much for joining in with your thoughts. But let's get back to the news with regards to the FII limit in the bonds actually being tweaked a little bit.